we will find the moment of inertia of some definite bodies is having shape, definite shape. First of all, we will find the moment of inertia of ring. There may be four cases. For example, this one is a ring, the top view, the center. This one is also ring. This is a case, axis perpendicular to the plane of the ring. The case, diameter rotating about this one. The case that is rotating about the tangent, which is parallel to the plane of the ring, and this will be the case of tangent which is perpendicular to the plane of the ring. These are the four cases. Now, first of all, now the first case, moment of inertia of a ring about an axis passing through center of the ring and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, perpendicular to the plane of the ring. Okay, this one is a ring and the axis which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, the axis of rotation. Its mass is m and radius is r. A ring of mass m is rotating about an axis which is perpendicular to the plane, which is perpendicular to the plane and passing through the center of the ring. That is y and y axis, y dash axis. To find the inertia, suppose this ring is made up of small particles. Its length is delta L1, its length is delta L2, and length is delta L3, and so on. Suppose the complete ring is made up of small parts. Consider the ring is made up of small parts. That's delta L1, delta L2, delta L3, and so on. If we sum, find the sum of these lengths, then it becomes 2 pi r. So, delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3, that's 2 pi r. Question number 1. The mass of complete ring is m. So, the mass of, suppose, the mass of length delta L1 is M1. So M1 will be capital M upon 2 pi r into delta L1. The distance from the axis of rotation of this mass M1 means Mi of M1. Suppose I1, that will be M1 and r square means I1 will be M upon 2 pi r into delta L1. Into r square, the mi of the length delta L1. Similarly, moment of inertia of mi of delta L2, that's I2, will be m upon 2 pi r into delta L2 into r square. In this way, we can find the mi of all the parts. If we add these moment of inertia of each part, then it gives the total moment of inertia of the ring. Total Mi of ring, I will be I1 plus I2 and so on, means I will be M upon 2 pi r delta L1 r square plus M upon 2 pi r delta L2 r square and so on, means I will be M upon 2 pi r and r square as common. becomes delta L1 plus delta L2. But from equation 1, the value of this one is 2 pi r. So I will be m upon 2 pi r into r square into 2 pi r. This one is cancelled. Means moment of inertia of the ring, I will be, I is m r square. And the moment of inertia of the ring about the axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane of the ring. We know that because of I is mk square, here k is radius of gyration. So mk square is equal to m r square, means we can write the ratio of k square upon r square for ring, that's 1. Or we can also write the value of k is r. Radius of gyration becomes equals to the radius of the ring. Now the second case, moment of inertia of ring, mi of ring about the diameter, about its diameter, a ring of mass m and radius r is rotating about its diameter ab. Means AB is the axis of rotation, that the ring axis of rotation passing through the center, it's AB, the axis of rotation. Consider another axis which is perpendicular to this axis, is also diameter CD, this angle is 90 degree, and if this one is x axis, then this will be y axis. Consider third axis, that's Z, the center O, the Z axis. Consider another axis CD. CD, which is perpendicular to AB. To AB, it means AB and CD both are diameter. They are mutually perpendicular. If AB is X axis, this one is X axis, then this will be Y axis, Z axis. OZ is the axis passing through the center of the ring and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, to the plane of the ring. We can easily apply the axis of perpendicular axis by perpendicular axis theorem. IZ will be IAB plus ICD. ICD, because of AB and CD both are diameter. So we can also write IZ is ID diameter. It's also IB because of MR square is IZ is MR square. Here IZ is m r square, that is 2 times ID, or we can also write ID, moment of inertia of the ring about its diameter is half m r square. If we change the axis of rotation, then the radius of gyration will change. Here k square upon r square will be 1 by 2, implies that k is equal to r by root 2. The moment of inertia about the axis, which is passing through the center or in the plane, it means the diameter of the ring. Now the third case, moment of inertia of ring about tangent, which is in the plane of the ring. This is the ring and this is tangent, which is in the plane of ring, y and y dash. Rotating about this axis is the axis of rotation. The radius of this ring is capital R, the center O dash, it's O, radius is R, its mass is capital M, Consider another axis which is parallel to the axis of rotation and also parallel. These are the parallax. Then by the parallaxis theorem, IO is IO dash plus M R square. Here IO dash is the axis passing through the center of the ring. It means it will be the diameter. IO is IB, that's half MR square. Here IO dash is the axis passing through the center and parallel to the axis of rotation. It's the diameter. So I will be IB. And ID we have already found is half MR square. So IO will be half MR square plus MR square. Means IO becomes, IO will be 3 by 2 MR square. The moment of inertia about the tangent, which is in the plane of the ring. From this one we can easily find k square upon r square is 3 by 2. It implies that k is root 3 by 2 r. Now the fourth case, that's moment of inertia of a ring about the tangent. Which is perpendicular to the plane of the ring. This one is a ring. It is a tangent passing through O and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, the axis of rotation. The center. Consider another axis which is parallel to the axis of rotation and passing through the center of the ring. The distance between these two parallel axes will be r. Mass of the ring is m. This axis will be z axis, which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane. So by the parallaxis theorem, this point is O dash. IO will be IO dash plus MR square. Because of IO dash is the axis which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, that's MR square. So IO will be MR square plus MR square, means IO is 2 MR square. The moment of inertia of the ring about tangent which is perpendicular to the plane of the ring. From here we can easily find k square upon r square will be 2. It implies that k is equal to square root of 2 r. These are the all four cases of the ring. Now one numerical question related to ring. Find moment of inertia of a ring of mass 2 kg and radius 1 meter about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to the plane of ring. Also find MI about its diameter. Now the solution. Given mass of the ring that's capital M is 2 kilogram. Radius of the ring that's R is 1 meter. To be find moment of inertia, moment of inertia of ring about the axis passing through center and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, I is mr square, mr square, or I will be 2 into 1 square, that's 2 kilogram into meter square, the SI unit of moment of inertia. Now the moment of inertia about diameter, moment of inertia of ring about diameter, that's I is half mr square, or I will be half into 2 into 1 square, so I will be 1 kilogram into meter square. That's the answer.